good horse. I was over in Australia for Christmas and New Year, did a festival in Queensland. We were snowed in at our house, managed just to get out, arrived in Australia for all the floods. Queensland, the house we stayed in on Christmas Eve, 2 weeks later, was underwater. So it was a great festival, despite the rain, and all the Australians had their wellies on, absolutely unperturbed. All this rain pouring on, gushing down the hillside, like a water feature, right through the marquee, under everybody's seats. It was on a slope, right? And all the water was just rippling. Not just splodgy, but rippling under the stage and down the rest of the hill. Warm water, I have to say, man. Warm rain. Makes a bit of a difference, you know, when your feet aren't cold in them wellies. Anyway, on the way back, we had a bit of holiday, a bit of spare time. We changed flights in Singapore, and Pat fancied going to Phuket in Thailand, and I fancied going to Cambodia or Vietnam, but I couldn't make my mind up, so Pat said, Phuket, we'll go to Thailand. And we had 2 good weeks in Phuket, and we recommended to anybody. And while we went from Phuket to Bangkok, and in Bangkok, the Thai currency is the baht, the Thai baht. And then there's about 50 baht to the pound, and your money goes a long way. And for 1 baht in Bangkok, I bought myself a hat. And I brought it home with me, and it was only when I was going past Harrogate and Skipton to Lancashire, I saw a road sign, and it reminded me there's only one other place in the world where you can buy a baht hat. I do apologise to those that are wondering what the others are chuckling at. Yeah, it's been a handicap of mine. Since I first went professional, I've found that there's a lot of things I say, I find them hilarious. I've seen audiences go, what the hell? There's one audience had a whip around trying to get me therapy. While I was in Barnstaple, they were telling me that the Cornish pasty now has to be made in Cornwall to be called a Cornish pasty. And they were up in arms, the Devon people. I said, why don't you lot get together and patent black pudding? Because if you sell it as Devon clotted blood, wouldn't it? Nobody would want to pinch that name off of them, would they? Love it, mate. There's a shop in Loftus where I live, a butcher's, and he makes black pudding. But he doesn't let it set. He just cuts the end up and he just sells it as a clot. And it's sort of, yeah, you can dip. Oh, well, yeah. Yeah, and you get a free statin with it. Have a song, the Turner's song. All right, it's good in that. Here's the one, look. You've heard of Rudyard Kipling, haven't you? Everybody's heard of Rudyard Kipling.
Yeah, he makes the cakes.
Eh?
He makes the cakes.
That's it. That's it, yes. Devon clotted blood cakes. Yeah, well anyway, there's a lot of people, particularly down south, are not aware of the fact that Rudyard Kipling, for the first half of the 20th century, Rudyard Kipling was probably the most popular sport in the northeast of England. And every town and village had its Rudyards. Hartlepool had a huge set of Rudyards. My dad and my Uncle Ernie used to go Kipling over there every Saturday. And Uncle Ernie was a champion Kipler. He had loads of awards. He went up and down the country winning all sorts of competitions. And When the sport started to win in the 50s, Uncle Ernie was devastated. My dad was upset. When they demolished the Rudyard and Hartley Bowl, they were broken, the pair of them. I remember my dad coming home, about 1956, I was only a kid, but he hung up his kibble bat for the very last time, you know, and it was so sad, so sad. Anyway, there's another Rudyard Kipling, a poet, not so well known. And he wrote a poem, a philosophical poem called If, which is a pretty impressive poem, despite the fact that nobody named their children after him. Anyway, it's Rudyard Kipling's If, and I wrote a tune for it about 25 years ago, and I used to sing it unaccompanied, but I can play it now. If you can keep your head when all about you were losing theirs and blaming it on you, if you can trust yourself when all men doubt you, but make allowance for their doubting too, if you can wait and not be tired of waiting or being lied about, don't deal in lies or being hated, don't give way to hating, and yet don't look too good or talk too wise. If you can dream and not make dreams your master, if you can think and not make thoughts your grave, if you can meet with triumph and disaster and treat those two imposters just the same, if you can bear to hear the truth you've spoken, twisted by nature, make a trap for fools, or watch the things you gave your life to broken and still build them up with worn out tools. If you make one heap of all your winnings and risk it on one turn of pitch and toss, and lose and start again at your beginnings, but never breathe a word about your loss. If you can force your heart, your nerve and sinew to serve your turn long after the day you're gone, and so hold on when there is nothing in you except the will that says to them hold on. If you can talk with crowds and keep your virtue, or walk with kings, nor lose the common touch, if neither foes nor loving friends can hurt you, if poor men count with you but not too much, if you can fill the unforgiving minutes with 60 seconds worth of distant run, yours is the earth and everything that's in it, and which is more, you'll be a man, my son.